everyone. I'm Larry Ridley, and this is the NFL on EA Sports. We're all set to bring you a terrific contest here as these two divisional rivals renew acquaintances for the first time this season. There's always a little something extra at stake when these teams face off.
It's the Texans going up against the Titans.
The opening kick is straight ahead, so it's time to turn it over to my colleagues, Brandon Godden and Charles Davis with the call. Gentlemen.
All right, thank you, Larry. We are across the Cumberland River from downtown Nashville at Nissan Stadium in Tennessee. Today, it's week three, and we've got a good one in store between the Houston Texans and the Tennessee Titans. One receiver left, two to the right. First down, Mariota. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down. Really good defensive effort. They were all over that little swing pass out to the right side, but for lost yardage.
Terrific read, better execution, and done with a lot of enthusiasm, wasn't it?
Absolutely.
They saw it all the way, ran to the football, and cause a nice play for lost yardage.
A little bit of ground to make up for the offense as they face a second and 11. Now a second down throw for Mariota. And he'll be hit as he releases it, and that'll fall incomplete. As we get a glance at the starting lineup offensively, let's discuss the former Heisman Trophy winner, Derrick Henry.
He was definitely disappointed that he dropped to the second round. Only one running back went in the first. That was Ezekiel Elliott. But I think Derrick Henry has a chance to have a special NFL career. He's not just big and strong, has way better feet than he's ever been given credit for.
Little trouble thus far on their opening drive as they come up on a third and 11. On third down, Mariota. Lead.
It's always tough for the guys throwing the football when they think they've got a completion and the ball's almost there, and then someone sneaks a hand or two in and bats it away.
On fourth down, here's Brett Kern to punt the football away. Returnable here from the 38. Give him 11 yards that time on the return. And the Texans take possession. They come up in an offset eye. From the midfield stripe, they'll look to throw. And he's got his man on the out route. That one good for 10 yards. And that'll make it second and a foot or so.
But it appears that they read man defense and went to the out route. And what you have to do on that one is the receiver's got to make sure he works the defender towards the middle of the field to give himself space to cut to the outside and have that ball delivered with good timing. And they got it done.
All right.
dive. Here's the fullback crotch. And he'll get it down on the play to the 37. Only three there on the pickup, but that's enough to move the chains.
I don't know about you, partner, but on second and inches, a lot of the times I'm leery about the offensive guys thinking about taking a shot downtown. Instead, they just hand it to the big man and let him rumble forward for a first down.
Watch it now, Barney, Barney.
All right, here we go.
Detroit, here we go. Detroit.
They'll look to throw here on first down. The catch made by DeAndre Hopkins. And he's brought down. It's a gain of 14 there. And it'll give the Texans a first down.
I think that's a big pickup for a first down, because when you run a drag route against zone, you're sometimes asking for trouble because you might run into a defender.
Yeah, well, there they ran into a first down, executed it to perfection. And they'll go with a ground attack here. And he's brought down. It's a gain of 20 that time. And the Texans are going to have a first and goal.
Hey, we all know it's turned into a passing league in the NFL, but that doesn't mean people still don't like to run the football. When you run it that successfully, your offensive line is fired up. What they want to do each and every game is run block. Get out.
And he gets into the end zone. Touchdown, Houston. A great play there. His third touchdown now on the year. And the Texans have taken the early lead. And the Texans take a 7-0 lead. Now after the touchdown, it's Sturgis to send it away. This one fielded at the 5. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. And the Titans getting set to go. And a 3-and-out on that first drive. We'll see if they can do better here.
They should have a better opportunity because the nerves should be settled now. That first series, everybody goes out a little extra emotion. So now they get a chance to go back out and say, okay, now we're into the game. Let's go play and play as best we can.
You almost get a mulligan then on that first drive.
Sometimes it absolutely serves that way. You get a second opportunity. Nothing big happened. But then again, you didn't commit any mistakes either. Off you go. And the game just keeps evolving. Big guys running those corner routes, so difficult to cover.
At the 35. That's going to go as a loss of 2, and it'll be second down.
That play never got off the ground because of the defensive front. They owned the offensive line, which allowed the linebackers to see their openings and run straight to the ball. That's why that play just never had a chance.
Mariota now on second down. And a quick throw here, that's complete. And he'll bring it up here to right at the 40-yard line. The defensive crew for the Texans, here's a look.
Demaryius Randall's a versatile player. Played both safety and cornerback in college. They're using those same skills in the NFL.
Third down now following the completed pass. To throw Mariota, and he finds Jason Morrow, and he will have the first down as he's brought down up near midfield.
I heard so much about the offense Marcus Mariota ran while he was at Oregon, about how people were just wide open, how he couldn't fail to hit them, but I always said the same thing. He sure as heck didn't miss him very often. Very accurate, even on short throws.
Yeah, he can go short, he can go deep, obviously, but he's really good with that short passing game.
Dart thrower, very accurate. Receivers love him.
So here we go, first and 10 now. They'll run it now out of the gun. And able to push his way forward here for a good little game. And give him 4 yards there. It'll be 2nd and 6.
Not a run that you're going to write home about, but still a good first down run. That's what an offense calls staying on schedule. 3 to 4 yards on first down, you're set up very well for the rest of the drive.
Second down, Mariota. And over the middle here, Amaro. And he's brought down. And the play goes for 19 yards. Gives him a new set of downs.
And after that completion, you can understand why so many teams in the league are emphasizing speed on defense at every position. The tight ends have created so many tough matchups now. If you can't run with a tight end as a linebacker, this is going to be the result every time.
And the offense lining up 1st and 10. They go play action here on 1st down. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. It'll be a gain of 4, and it's a 2nd down. And just in general, Charles, on a play like that, how tough is it for the defense to account for a running back essentially being a receiver downfield?
It's very difficult, especially if the running back has skills like a receiver, and you're aware of that before the game even begins. So throughout your practice sessions, you're going to want to be aware of him. Where is he lining up? What can he do? What kind of damage can he do to us downfield? And who can match up with him without weakening our overall defense? You're exactly right. It's a tough task to match up to him.
And he will score. Touchdown, Titans. Derrick Henry. His first touchdown here of the new campaign. And the Titans are an extra point away from tying this thing up. It's good, and we're all tied at 7 apiece. So we're right back where we started. All even as the kick's away. And that'll carry over the back line of the end zone for a touchback. And now out comes Houston. And that recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and thought there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. Avery Williamson there to make the stop. Offensive starters here. Wide receiver DeAndre Hopkins, a talented, talented wide receiver.
And he's still looking for that ultimate recognition. He wants to be mentioned with the best receivers in the game. His numbers suggest that we should do so.
Hopkins on the grab over the middle. And he takes this one just shy of midfield all the way to the 49. So the offense has it 1st and 10.
Hurry up, here we go. Boom, landing.
They're going to look to throw. Right side complete. That's Woods. And he'll be brought down at the 45-yard line. It'll be a gain of 6, and it'll make it a 2nd down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
So they complete the pass, and now they face a 2nd down. They come out here in the eye. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play that time, and they'll look to convert on what will be a 3rd and 4. With Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon, and it's Texans football as we get going in quarter number 2. They're on the march, but facing a 3rd down here.
Three.
One receiver left, three to the right. Out of the gun now on third down. And he can't hang on to it. Nearly picked. He's known for his hands defensively. But instead, it just brings up fourth down.
Pretty nice coverage there, but a missed opportunity for an interception. Let's face it, a lot of these defenders, they've got it all. Speed, athleticism, hands, a little bit questionable.
And that'll be off the crossbar and out. It's short. He couldn't get it there. It's no good. And this game will remain tied here in quarter number two. All things considered, a pretty good kick. Just cruel punishment there to be denied by the crossbar.
If you're going to hit from that distance, sometimes you're going to need a little luck. And unfortunately for him, this time the break goes against him.
Here on first down, and this is incomplete.
Normally he's pretty reliable, usually catches what's thrown to him. On that play, he simply dropped it.
Still needing 10 yards. Second down. Henry, the lone man in the backfield. And they'll give it to him here. And that play goes nowhere. Taken down, losing yardage at the 50, right at midfield. It's a loss of two. Now third down.
To me, that's a superior play by the backer because he was allowed to, I think, run free on it and make that play. His defensive linemen, they covered things down for him because offensive guys, the linemen, what they're trying to do, as you know, is block the guy at the point of attack and then climb to the next level and get the linebacker. And you're not allowed to climb. You got a free hitter, and that's what we saw there. And a really nice play resulted for them.
The 21 yards there as they convert on third.
Well, the advantage certainly shifted to the defense as we began that third down play, and they found a way to foil it and pick up a first down.
Third time's a charm, right? Two incompletions. Had to have it on third, and they got it.
Yeah, they stuck with it, weren't daunted at all, and picked it up.
And now a first down following that long gain. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to fight his way forward here for a modest gain. He'll get a nice chunk there on the first down run, and it's second and four.
Some runs are blocked so well, you almost forget that someone has to carry the ball to gain the yardage. The leverage by the offensive line to create space up front, really well done.